I had a feeling I'd be making another video on these goofballs. I can't even deny it at this point. I don't know what it is with the district making so many shitty decisions in such a short period of time, but if these bastards are good for anything, it's confusing the fuck out of everyone with the garbage they get on with. I'm not looking to make a 20 minute video on a group of old bags though, so I'll try to keep this video as short as I can get it. To sum it up, the Nlesd has done a piss poor job at handling the back to school situation. If you're one of the poor bastards going through the school system this year, you knows that I'm speaking the truth. To start off, the entire concept of social distancing doesn't work when you got 40 to 50 kids crammed together in a single classroom. Or when you've got 700 kids leaving the fucking building at the same time through one set of double doors. Mask or not, the system they got in place is total bullshit. Speaking of masks, that's where my next issue lies. Don't get me wrong, I'm not one of those arseholes who thinks that masks are for pussy whip bitches, but for Jesus sake, when I looks at the numbers, I can't help but feel that all of this is a bit overboard. We've got like one active case in Newfoundland, but if you were to go to one of these schools, you'd probably confuse it for a Fallout fucking vault or some shit. Masks non-stop, strict distancing rules, shorter lunches, no going outside for a recess, and posters plastered on every fucking wall, reminding you to help stop the spread. I never knew the fucking spread started, but alright. That recess thing seems to be getting some lot of people poisoned though. Everywhere I looks on me Snapchat stories, I see someone bitching about it. So in order to rake up the view count a little bit, I'll throw in my two cents. Now what the argument seems to be from the average teacher's perspective is that by cutting recess out, they're reducing contact between students as they're leaving and entering the building. But even if we do accept that, there's still the fact that 600 people are leaving out of the same fucking doors at the end of the day anyways. So the whole less contact thing doesn't work. Like, no matter how you fucking look at it, it's a stupid, stupid system. That reminds me, in some schools, youngsters aren't even allowed to be late anymore. That's right, the classic pastime of truancy can't even bring in the laughs anymore. Mortal fucking Simba. But if I'm being serious, locking the doors after a certain time is just fucking retarded, man. I know I've been going back to it a fair bit, but how can you be fine with having 600 to 800 people leaving through a set of double doors at the end of the day, yet at the same time make showing up 5 minutes late on a Monday morning worthy of fucking your whole morning schedule over? Like, I don't know if any of these assholes ever drove in traffic before, but to sum it up, you aren't always guaranteed to have a traffic-free fucking Sunday ride to school. The reason why I'm bringing this up though is because one of me buddies actually had this rule enforced on him a few days back. He showed up to school 3 minutes past the cutoff time, and none of the teachers would let him in. Oh, they seen him, yes, but they wouldn't let him in, they wouldn't give him the fucking buzz. Now let me remind you, this kid never touched a drug in his life. And I guarantee you there isn't a sloppy file on his fucking record. But even though this kid did nothing wrong other than experience shitty traffic on a Wednesday, he had to be punished because of a bullshit social distancing rule that the district enforced. Now if it were me, I would have been practicing social distancing from me fucking bedroom from that point on, no joking around. But that isn't the worst part. After around an hour and a half, they finally let this buddy in, and instead of just letting him go after class, minding his own business, they gives him this big old lecture about how he's putting the lives of other students at risk by entering the building at such a late part of the day, 3 minutes in, mind ya. I'm not sure what happened next, but I hope to God that me buddy told him where to go and how to get there. But I wants to comment on that before I moves on to me final point. I'm not the most up-to-date person in the world, but I wants to know when blaming the world's problems on kids became such a fashionable thing. A kid shows up 3 minutes late, big fucking deal. Maybe his parents were in a fight, maybe traffic was slow, maybe he had to walk, but no. Suffocate all the youngsters under the corona blanket. That'll teach him some respect, won't it? I'm not blaming any of the teachers, by the way. I respects all of them 100%. Like, they're the most underpaid people on the planet, I'm telling you right now. If the district never had any of these bullshit rules in place, this video probably wouldn't have been made. That's who the fucking target of this is. The teachers have nothing at all to do with it. The final point of the day has to do with the public exams, and St. Bridget the night do I got some shit to spew on this. As of right now, the public exams for non-semesterized youngsters are still going ahead. Even though the district made such a huge deal about the COVID-19 restrictions and the supposed safety of the children, They must have glassed over the fact that these grade 12 kids are coming off a 6-month hiatus without learning half of their grade 11 year. Yet the NLESD thinks that they should have more than half of their grade at stake in midterms and public exams. Makes total sense to me. In all seriousness though, if I were in high school right now, which I may or may not be, I can guarantee you that my mental health would be up Schitt's Creek. All the dumb high school bullshit, mixed in with a global pandemic, mixed in with work, mixed in with YouTube, mixed in with public exams and midterms. Fuck semesterized, I'd be institutionalized at that point. Give me a lobotomy or something, just ease the fucking pain. With all the shit that's been on the go in the world over the past year, I think giving the grade 12s a break wouldn't hurt you too bad. But hey, when has the district ever been wrong about a decision they've made? Besides the frauding, corruption, underpayment to teachers especially, and pissing away class resources, they've got a really, really clean record, but don't judge them. To end off, I'm predicting this year to go off without a hitch. The youngsters are gonna suffer, but hey, at least the district heads make money off of them. All in all, you're just another brick in the wall. But to end off on a final message for the district heads, I just wanted to let you know that you're out of touch, I'm out of time, and I'm out of my head when you're not around. This has been Leif Carlo, and I'll see you on the right side of the rock. Have a good one.
A man's anus is leaked like this by the other person,
like ice cream.
And then what happens, even poo-poo comes out, the other poo-poo's out, and then they eat the poo-poo. The other one they do is they have a sex practice called feasting.